Hi, I'm Korey Pham, and I'm a PhD student with the Department of Entomology at LSU. Today, I'm going to be telling you about native pollinators and how to build native pollinator hotels in your own backyard. Globally, native pollinator populations are declining. Without native pollinators and honeybees, we would be without a third of our crops across the United States. And that includes watermelon, apples, blueberries, squash, and many other crops that are vital to our agriculture. There are many different native pollinators, including wasps, bees, flies, and beetles. But today we're going to be focusing on what does a native pollinator bee look like. So sometimes they can be different colors, such as the blue orchard bee. They are also most of the time very specialized in a specific vegetable or crop, such as the alfalfa leafcutter bee, the squash bee. There's also the southeastern blueberry bee. And the bee that we most commonly think about when you hear the word bee is the honeybee. But honeybees are actually not native. They are brought in from Europe or Asia. So we do not have a United States native honeybee. So we want to focus a little bit more on helping the native pollinators that are already here that are native in Louisiana. Today, I'm going to be teaching you how to build a native bee hotel. So in order to build a native bee hotel, you need some supplies, but you don't have to rush to the store to get your own supplies to build a bee hotel. You can find these supplies around your house, such as an empty soup can, a milk jug or a sweet tea jug, little pots, any shape or size, and you can also even use a terracotta pot. Or a tubware container that's more of a box shape. You can also order a birdhouse. You also need to buy some nesting tubes, or you could also make your own, which I can show you a little bit later on. And the tubes look like this, and they're just made out of cardboard. Now that you have your final bee hotel, you can place it in your garden beds. So you can either hang it on a hook attached to your eaves, or you can place it down low close to your flowering vegetables or flowering bushes. Thank you for joining me.